We get so many letters and comments from Facebook and Twitter and Minds and American Thinker, and there's still a lot of stuff rolling around on YouTube that where other people post my videos. So it's hard for me to try to read all the comments. I really learn a lot from the comments. But the ones I comment back on are the ones where I think it's worth for a lot of other people to see as well. It's worth other people kind of learning a lesson from these comments as well. So here, and that's what this comment falls under. I think it was on one of my Facebook pages. It's from Denise Jefferson. Denise pretends that she wants me to tell my story so I will feel better about myself and the world, so I could go out and teach the world to sing in perfect harmony. Quote, I think your followers need to know where all the hatred is coming from. I know it is painful, but you will be surprised at how much better you will feel. I really hate how you denigrate my race and especially our sons, but I'm being real here. Okay, so what kind of mind, what kind of twisted mind, no matter how nice you think you are, no matter how nice you're trying to pretend you are, what kind of twisted mind do you have if you are looking at videos on this channel, if you're looking at one episode of black violence after another, one episode of black people beating the hell out of a white person after another, and you look at the white victims, and you look at the people who stand up for the white victims, the Asian victims, the old, the young, the gay, the straight, the Amish, the Eskimos, the kitties, puppies, turtles, and goldfish, the person who sticks up for them against people like you, Denise. You say sticking up for the person that's in the hospital right now that almost got killed on the streets of New York like we're seeing right now. You say that's hate. Hey, Denise, got some really, really, really bad news for you. It is you who have organized your life around race. It is you who have made race the central organizing feature of your life. You denigrate my race. Everybody I know doesn't play the race card. The people I know in my own life, most of them anyway, they're just people, they're just individuals trying to make something happen for them. And if anybody came out and started talking about my race, they'd be scorned and mocked mercilessly until they gave up. So here you are, Denise, looking all these episodes from New York City, from Dallas. You're going to see one from Moline. You're going to see one from Fort Worth. And you look at them and say, anybody who calls you out for enabling that, for being in denial and deceit and delusion about that, is full of hate. No, anybody who looks at this stuff and pretend it's not happening, that's where the hate is. You know, if you read psychological books, I wonder if Scott Adams, I may or may not have read this one of Scott Adams' books, but if you read books about persuasion, you know, they always tell you to do which we never do around here on purpose. So if you want to talk about somebody's, you know, somebody writes an article, they say, you could say, boy, Colin, you really made some good points in that article, except for boom, 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 boom. Or, boy, you really, I really like the way your clothes, except for the fact that you're 400 pounds. So whenever you're going to drop a truth bomb on somebody, they always want you to drop a little sympathy bomb to kind of soften them up beforehand. We don't do that here. We don't play the little apology game here. We see what's happening. We see the determination and denial, deceit, and delusion from people who are in full-on hate mode. Those people are dangerous. People like Denise Jefferson are dangerous. And we call them out every day. And we don't really care if it makes the black kids angry.